Hi, welcome to Criminology Unit 3, AC 1.3, How Evidence is Processed. Now, this section on the whole is not very well done in the exam, and the reason for that is quite straightforward, okay? You have to talk about both physical evidence and testimonial evidence, and it's quite easy to talk about physical, but less straightforward to talk about testimonial evidence. Now, for both types of evidence, you have to either refer to the brief and give real life examples. And where it gets a little bit tricky, certainly for testimonial evidence, is talking about collection, transfer, storage, analysis. Okay, so just to recap, now you've done this in class hopefully. Physical evidence is anything you can physically touch. It can be biological samples, it could be fingerprints, it could be blood, it could be any of those sort of biological substances which are found in and around a crime scene, it could be a weapon, things like that. Okay, so it's obviously hopefully going to be collected at the crime scene, it's going to be transferred to the lab in a certain way and stored in a certain way and analysed in a certain way, and the people involved in that will be the forensic scientists and possibly forensic experts. Now, if you look at the Henderson textbook, they've got a really good section here on how different pieces of physical evidence are dealt with. We are not a forensics course, as you know, so we don't do any of this for real, but knowing how it is done is really important. So, for example, most biological samples are kept in paper rather than plastic because plastic sweats and therefore there could be a degradation of the quality of the sample. So things like spatters of blood will be collected on paper. So when you're writing up physical evidence, collection, transfer, storage and analysis is quite straightforward. Testimonial evidence, which is obviously the spoken word and the word of witnesses and the word of victims, is actually much more difficult to apply these sections to. But I would refer you to the Ron Cotton videos. If you remember, Ron Cotton was the victim of mistaken identity, and you've already covered his case when looking at eyewitness testimony. But the second follow-up video was actually really good because it made the point about how the police have to be really careful when interviewing witnesses, when showing witnesses photographs and organising identity parades, that they've got to be really careful that they don't suggest anything to the witnesses or the victims which could then sort of taint their memories. So that collection of testimonial evidence is really important, okay, that it's done in a very, very unbiased way. So when you're writing these up, do use real life examples and do refer to the brief where possible, okay. When you're writing up physical evidence, I wouldn't be using a whole load. I might just go for biological samples maybe, because, you know, like I say, in the Henderson textbook, there's lots of examples of how different types of physical evidence is collected. You've only got 6 marks, 3 marks are essentially for physical evidence, 3 marks for testimonial. So try and get some balance in your written work there. Okay, good luck.